Who are you and what is your job occupation title?
Mr. Griffith, I'm the principal here at Shaker Hights High School. I've been part of what's happened here since its beginnings. It's obviously grown tremendously. We now have teachers all over the district, every level. We're connected with the Confucius Classroom. We were part of that. And I know CSU and all over the country, that's a huge thing.
好的，上课。
Confucius Classroom is not the individual classroom. It's based on the Chinese organization we call the Hanban to promote the Chinese language all over the world. And we are part of the organization called financially and teaching materially, professionally support from them for years. And that is also the organization who sent me to State of Ohio. In the Confucius Institute in college level in Cleveland State, we have a strong partnership with them because we pretty much start at the same year in K-12 level we call Confucius Classroom.
I think that connection, obviously, as I said, it's about 7 years old. It's really exploded in terms of the breadth of it. When you think about Ms. Lee now, and then all of the other teachers that have come that are here, you know, in a visiting capacity. So that relationship, in terms of both them bringing their culture here, our opportunity to go there, they're deeply committed to learning about our culture, you know, the English, but also in the, you know, American culture. So I think that's just going to, as I said, continue to expand. Because of the Confucius Classroom and all the universities now connected in that, and Columbus connected in that through Ohio Department of Education, it's going to just continue, I think, to expand and deepen. You've got I think in Shaker, the Chinese community is very strong, and their Saturday program and all those kinds of things. So I think it's going to be fabulous. It will continue to deepen, and I see it as a complete total mesh. You know, where, as I said, we'll have teachers, students, back and forth.
Good morning. My name is Les Foote. I'm a Spanish teacher and I'm also the department chair of the high school world language department. As department chair, I also act as a liaison between the teachers and the administration and, fulfilling the duties of department chair. But essentially, I'm a colleague of Ms. Lee. Been at Shaker for a number of years, so I was here when the Chinese program got started at its inception, and I've watched it grow over the years. It's been a pleasure to see that. Any program, whether it's language studies, sports, in the arts, anything that we get involved with, it comes down to the people who are in charge of the program. I think that's the strength of Shaker's Chinese program. Ms. Lee is dynamic, she's talented, she's intelligent, and she's very committed to the program. And all of that has resulted in just, you know, continuous growth and a lot of success. She does as much as can possibly be done to bring the culture into the lessons.
I'm Li Lao Shi, Lu Ling, Reina Li. I'm a Chinese teacher in Shaker Hights High School since 2006, and also a coordinator for Confucius Classroom in Shaker Hights High School. And recently got another title as a coordinator of Cleveland area for Ohio Teacher Association of Teaching Chinese. Long story short, I came here as a volunteer teacher. It was based on the program between the Chinese organization called Hanban and Ohio Department of Education. Went through the interview and came here, signed up the contract for 3 years, 1 to 3 years. I started learning English since grade 3 and take actual curriculum outside of school district. And everyone in China taking Chinese, everyone in K-12, we have to pass the English test. Until I graduate from high school, I've never ever talked to any native speaker. The world is so small after all the technology brought to our life. And WeChat, QQ, Skype, and email, it's very convenient to us. I grew up in the second large city in northeastern part of China, province called Heilongjiang, and city's name is Qiqihar. And it's a minority group language, means borderline. So relatively small, but the cities in that city is 5 million. And the culture is kind of diverse and unique. We got a strong influence from Mongolia, Korean, Japanese, and Russian. So the food is delicious with grilled barbecue, kimchi, and sushi. The people are very direct to each other. So nice friends can make a good friends there. And the winter time is really cold. It's famous for the ice sculpture in that province. And it's like 20 degrees colder than Cleveland. So when the first year I came here, they were telling me, it is really cold in Cleveland. And to me, I feel so lucky, it's so warm.
What thoughts do you have on the infusion of International Baccalaureate into the language curriculum?
I am absolutely delighted that we're heading in that direction. I think it's very good for overall for the whole school, but in particular, I think it's good for the World Language Department. As you know, there's a very strong component of language acquisition in the diploma program, so that can only be good for the World Language Department and enrollment in the World Language Department. I think it's good for the students. I think that's a proper emphasis. I think that second language acquisition is something that has been ignored by and large in the United States. And the International Baccalaureate, because it is international, you know, addresses that need. And we're behind the rest of the world in terms of, you know, being bilingual, whether it's bilingual in English and Chinese or English and Spanish or, you know, whatever language, very, very few Americans are. And in other countries, it's more common.
I think it's a perfect match with where we are in terms of the IB program and what we're trying to develop. So I anticipate that more and more students who are coming up from the elementaries, having that context in the way that they look at learning, are going to embrace these programs all the more.
我的生日in what day?
You can do that. Very good. 很好。我的生日。
Excellent.
Okay, my name is Jen Huyan. I'm Chinese teacher. About a year and a half here in Shaker. I work with sixth graders at Woodbury and seventh graders at the middle school.
In Shaker, all the elementary school class, Chinese class, we do not necessarily require assessment or evaluation, so no quiz or test or homework. So pretty much all the activity we carry on during teaching 1 hour, 2 times per week. However, in high school, we have 1 hour per day, every day, and students are learning formally for 4 techniques of 4 languages, listening, speaking, reading, and writing.
I'm Jake Polster, and I'm a graduating senior at Shaker Hights High School. Ms. Lee has brought personality to teaching Chinese, and she hasn't just taught it right out of the book. She's given us culture lessons that involve her cooking food and bringing in people. Junior year, we had a performance at Asian Plaza in Cleveland, and we performed Beijing Huangyingni, which is a Chinese song that was written and produced for the Beijing Olympics in 2008, and basically the lyrics are Beijing Huangyingni and some other stuff. And that means Beijing welcomes you because it was welcoming all the different cultures and countries to China for the Olympics. First heard about Chinese through an older student who graduated last year, so he was a year ahead of us. And he was my family friend, and he told me about it, and he really enjoyed it, and so he suggested I take it, and I took it, and it was really worth it.
My name is Bulan Dun, Brandon. I am in 7th grade. I have been taking Chinese since 3rd grade. I picked Chinese class out of all 4 or 5 languages because I really like Chinese, speaking Chinese, and I always wanted to go to China, possibly for a trip, and it's really interesting. I like the culture.
The Chinese language itself is very difficult. It's a constantly thing I'm thinking, how do we make it easier for students to learn to pick up?
I think my teacher even suggested that it's going to be very influential in the future, right? Because like China's doing, like, if you look at everything, it's basically made in China, and they're going to need people who can speak Chinese in the future.
So obviously the job opportunity in the future, and what I heard last year, Chinese is trying to cooperate with American companies, either buying or joint adventure. They're just 1 year, there are about 650 companies, just 1 year last year. So it's obviously there are opportunities for students who has language knowledge.
I remember at each first day of my class, I passed out a survey to ask the students why do they want to learn Chinese, what do they know about China. And the first year, before I was a first teacher, it's even interesting to see the answer. Students know China from their history of social study class, and very limited information. Future, lots of people want to do business, and it's a big consumer country and big market. So also it's benefit for their future career.
If there's anything you could say to any of the middle schoolers or the middle schooler parents, kind of enticing them to take,
yeah,
you know, to take that extra step and venture out into taking an international language, what kind of things would you say to them?
You know, I think it's a no-lose proposition. First of all, have fun. I mean, this should be a fun thing. Language acquisition can be very enjoyable. It's work, of course. All learning is, you know, it requires some effort, but that doesn't mean that it can't be enjoyable at the same time. And I would just take it, you know, in small steps, especially a language as challenging as Chinese, for example. You're not going to learn it overnight. It's going to take lots of small steps, but those can be very enjoyable small steps, and the consequences, the rewards are immeasurable. I mean, you don't know, but as I say, it's a no-lose proposition. There's no reason for youngsters and parents not to get excited about it and to get involved in language learning.
If you're not involved in it, it's fantastic to get involved in it. And I would say look at it for more than just the language. So I would hope that people would consider doing Asian studies, doing IB, doing the Confucius, involving themselves in the Confucius classrooms and all of the programs, because it's the holistic perspective that it all brings together that really, really allows you. It's not that our other languages don't have that too, but this really deeply has a setting that allows you to really, I think, begin to embrace another world view, another world perspective, and another culture in a wonderful way. So I would encourage people to just immerse yourself in it. Just go for it.